As Larry David might say, the 2019 Hyundai Veloster is pretty good. The Seinfeld creator often says this with more than a little sense of relief and an acknowledgement of unexpectedly favorable outcomes for his bumbling travails in the show Curb Your Enthusiasm. Only there really isn't anything unexpected about the new, second-generation Veloster's satisfying overall execution. High's good thrust from turbo engine, great shifter, unflappable chassis. Lows could use a limit slip differential, lackluster noise from either engine, limited rear visibility. Hyundai is a couple generations into general competence and long ago became immune to cheap shots like Hyundai's are good for Korean cars. More recently, the automaker's grown ambitious about making its mainstream models more appealing to drive. Recently, sizzle has trickled into models as unpretentious as the price-ladder accent sedan and the Kona crossover. Snap, crackle, and pop have been less discriminatingly meted out to the Veloster. Mechanically similar to the Elantra GT hatchback, the Veloster has a squat, tapered body with pumped-out rear fenders and a commodious, if tight-to-access, 20 cubic foot cargo hold. Despite the fact that the redesign sports a faster roofline, Hyundai found more rear headroom, but not reduced blind spots or additional visibility to the rear, by moving the hatch hinges rearward. Materially, the interior is a huge improvement over the old Veloster's. Hard plastic still abounds, but it's grained nicely and is impeccably assembled. Simple and clear whitey and black gauges and Hyundai's ubiquitous touchscreen infotainment system blend into the straightforward, restrained cabin design. Each of the five trim levels is identifiable by different upholstery and pops of color on its seats and dashboard. And lest we forget, the Veloster still has an asymmetrical layout that places a single, longer door on the driver's side and a pair of stair apertures on the passenger side. The two rear seats can be accessed from either side, but entering from the left requires funneling oneself through the narrow gap between the driver's seat and the door jamb as in a regular two-door coupe. You'll either like this layout or you won't, but you won't find it on any competitor. Seriously, forget the door thing until the high-performance 275-horsepower Veloster N appears later this year. The Veloster Turbo is Hyundai's most focused performance machine. With its 201-horsepower turbocharged 1.6-liter inline four carried over from the old Veloster Turbo, firmed-up suspension, and available summer tires, it's a sought-off competitor to the Volkswagen GTI or the Honda Civic C. That the Veloster Turbo nearly matches those slightly larger, slightly pricier cars' specifications is classic Hyundai. We'll play along, to a point, but we prefer to think of the Turbo as a worthy successor to the half-size down, soon-to-be Ford Fiesta Street. There is a base Veloster, which uses a new Atkins cycle 2.0-liter engine with port fuel injection, sans turbo, to produce 147 horsepower and 132 lb-ft of torque. We snagged only a quick drive in that one, enough to determine that while a new engine is 15 horses and 12 lb-ft stronger than the 1.6-liter it replaces, it still makes more racket than forward motion when pressed. The upside? The chassis is as well tuned as the turbos, and the two models look nearly identical. Plus, it's a good deal at $19,385, which includes forward collision warning, automated emergency braking, lane keeping assist, cruise control, 17-inch wheels, automatic headlights, and a 7.0-inch touchscreen with Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. A 6-speed automatic costs $1,000, and it's standard on the more richly equipped $23,635 2.0 premium. Turbo FTW. The turbo lineup begins just $150 above the 2.0 premium with the $23,785 spec, which comes only with a 6-speed manual transmission. As far as we are concerned, the lineup could end there, too. The simply named $26,285 turbo can be had with a 7-speed dual-clutch automatic transmission. And although you can order the loaded Turbo Ultimate with a 6-speed manual, it'll cost $27,535. Equipping a Turbo Ultimate with the DCT adds $1,500. For more on which trim level gets what, read our pricing breakdown of the Veloster lineup. In our book, the spec represents the strongest value. Every turbo's suspension has thicker anti-roll bars and is roughly 15% stiffer than the base Veloster's. The only stick-shift turbos we drove were specs, which get a Trim-exclusive B&M short shifter kit. The setup's Honda-like shift quality is shockingly good, and the clutch pedal is springy and progressive with a clear take-up point in the middle of its stroke. Recently, we declared the Accent's manual transmission to be the best Hyundai has ever offered. Transfer the title with a hat tip to B&M to the Veloster spec now. The dual clutch transmission is less beguiling. Its responses to manual gear selections are disappointingly slow whether you use the steering wheel paddles or the shift lever, and several times we caught the computer snoozing, leaving us without a complete throttle blip to smooth a downshift. In automatic mode, it upshifts short of redline most of the time to ride the turbo engine's fat wave of torque in the low and middle ranges. Although not terribly sporty, the protocol feels effective and helps to avoid the shrill whooshing noises and softened thrust that occur near the engine's redline. The Dyson sound effect isn't unique in this segment. Honda Civic C is nearly as lacking in hype and character, but Hyundai curiously augments it, digitally, through the turbo's audio speakers. Every Veloster has normal, sport, and in automatic transmission models adaptive smart driving modes. In the turbo, these represent different volume settings in addition to changing the steering effort and throttle response. Fortunately, drivers can minimize or shut off the digital exhaust note altogether via the touchscreen. Handling, by Hyundai. Before our drive, Hyundai's Vice President of Product Planning, Mike O'Brien, declared the Veloster's chassis the best the automaker has ever presented to customers. No hyperbole there. Having traded its torsion beam rear axle and somewhat flexi body shell for a rear multi-link suspension shared with the Elantra Sport models and a stiff new structure, the Veloster is notably more refined and athletic than before, with the sharpest body control of any Hyundai we've driven. Chassis response on curvy roads was sublime, and the body never keeled over onto its outside front tire as so many front drive cars do. The suspension maturely irons out even brutal bumps without transmitting booms or crashes through the body or allowing any float, wheel flutter, or harshness. The Veloster's appeal to enthusiasts would be stronger if the handling allowed it to rotate a little more aggressively in tight corners. A different rear anti-roll bar might coax out some friskiness and lift throttle oversteer like that found in the Ford Fiesta Street. As things sit, the Veloster's rear end nicely tucks in behind the front when standing on the firm, responsible brake pedal heading into a turn, but it stays determinedly planted. Stick-shift turbo models ride on Michelin Pilot Sport 4 summer tires that sink the Veloster's claws even deeper into the pavement. This serious rubber has more turn and bite than the Nexon all-season tires found on automatic transmission turbos, even sneaking some road feel through the electrically boosted steering rack to the driver's hands. Every Veloster's steering is accurate, with a linear buildup of effort as cornering forces increase, a sharp contrast to the previous model's onset of vagueness and odd surges and dips in steering effort. As a bonus, the Michelins are notably quieter than the all-seasons at speed. Hyundai has so reduced the Veloster's wind and road noise that it's easy to pick out the Nexon subperoral signature. The skinny, laid-on thick if you can learn to love the Veloster's silly door layout, it's a blaring deal compared with other sweet driving compact hatchbacks such as the Mazda 3 and the Honda Civic Sport. The turbo is a blaring performance steal, and the one we buy. In spec guys, the Veloster is a mere $1,625 more than the incredibly cramped Fiesta ST, although dealers are marking those down heavily as Ford winds down its car production. Hyundai undercuts the Honda Civic C by $1,210 or $1,410 for an C with summer tires and the Volkswagen GTI by $3,480. That base GTI, by the way, is only $270 less costly than the full boat, manual transmission Veloster Turbo Ultimate. A Hyundai that's well-rounded, stylish, a value, and satisfying to drive. We're pretty, Pretty sure it won't be the last. Yeah.